this spirit has a feather on it. That feather is being caught in the wind. That's going to let me know the direction that the wind's going to push that. So when I throw this spear, the wind would catch it and it's going to veer with the direction of the wind. So that is an aiming tool. It also makes a nice decoration. Another thing is if I was taller, I may be able to throw the shaft further. But what I can do is take a stick. I can burn a hole in the back of it so that it makes a cup. Now I can hold the back of the shaft. I can also take a stick and just trim the limb off or tie something on it so that there's a stem that will catch the back of the shaft. I can actually throw approximately 4 times the distance that I can with just my hand throwing from the center, because I'm basically using my shoulder as the fulcrum. And with this throwing stick or an atlatl, I can now throw about 4 times as far. So, that's an improvement. I can now hit a target that's further away. Now, this dart is slightly shorter. It's about half the size. So, when I throw it, see what happens. Trees diverted it, but it'll actually go about twice as far. Half the size, twice as far. We've got another improvement or a slight change in technology, and that's the arrow. The arrow is basically a smaller atlatl dart. We have a stone point here. Notice this stone point is a lot smaller than the one we originally started out with. They figured out at some point that the idea with that force with a smaller point works just as well as having a large point. It actually works better. You can get more penetration with a smaller point. To deliver that, you have to have a different type of delivery system. The atlatl won't throw those. Well, they will, but not with the end. A bow, though, on the other hand, you have a different type with the curved ends, the wood. It basically creates a spring. When that arrow flexes, it stores the energy and allows it to release as it's going. We have a couple of arrows here, and I will shoot those. Similarly to that, we have smaller knives. These would have been for cutting the grass on your roof, cutting the flesh off of the deer that you're going to eat. Basically anything you need to cut, these are what you're going to use. This flint's very sharp. That's the reason for the handles. If you've got one that's shaped with a deep curve, it may just be wrapped with leather, and the leather becomes the handle. Likewise, you also have the chisels. So we already mentioned that they had no metal chisels. So those statues that y'all saw on the inside, they would have been made also with stone chisels, some kind of club or bat that you could hit the back of it.